Seating over 92,000 fans, Tiger Stadium in Baton Rouge is one of the biggest venues in college football. And now it's time for the coin toss, and it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. The pregame festivities are over, and we're just about set to get this game underway. Sends it sailing downfield. He's to the 20. And he just got drilled.
Hey, that's a pretty good return there to open this game up.
So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. Tackled after a decent pickup. From their own 42-yard line. Second down. Gets it out quickly to the back, but he can't haul it in.
A little sluggish on that series. I'm curious to see if they pick things up when they get the ball back.
Thomas back deep to return. It's away and it's a booming punt. And he's taken down at the 26-yard line. Miami's coaching staff, they know they've got a star wide receiver. They know it's going to be a hostile environment. With that, we went to practice this week, Kirk. They had the crowd noise pumped up pretty good getting them ready for this game.
Yeah, they've done everything that they can do to get this offense ready for a tough environment. They had the crowd noise all week long, making it tough to communicate for the quarterback and his receivers. Now it's here. Now it's the game. And we'll see if all that preparation pays off. One thing we know for sure, they want to get the football into the hands of this receiver early and often if they want to win this game.
Second and five, ball on their own 31. Pitch play to the left. They go to the left for a nice game. Really one of the very tough places to play in college football, and it's no different today. Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete. Doesn't look like he's going to have much time to get rid of this punt. Oh, excellent punt. Oh, man, he took him down hard. I don't think either team has a clear advantage so far. Let's see if they can make some plays and get a little separation. Fires right side, got his tailback. And he's tackled at the 34-yard line. Second down, 7 yards to go. Ball on the 34-yard line. Steps up and he's sacked for a loss.
You can't take sacks like that as a quarterback. You just can't. If you can't find a receiver, get out of the pocket and throw the ball away.
Third down and 14 to go. Ball on the 26-yard line. He fires. Can't hang on. Incomplete. The punt upcoming, and they're going to come after this one. He got hit hard. LSU LSU's defense looks like it's ready to feed off this crowd all game long. It's like having an extra player out there.
It sure is, Brad. They are off to a great start in that opening series. Let's see how they play here. Again, trying to just set the tone here early in this game in this next series.
Every drive's important in a tie game. I look for both sides to come out with some urgency. On the ground, and he won't get back to the line. We've got a second and 11. Ball on their own 37. That's a great tackle at the 30-yard line. This crowd can really be intimidating for an opposing team. He chucks it downfield. The defender had it and then dropped it. Dillon is back to receive. Let's get some points going right now. Not a lot of offense here in the opening quarter.
I'm with you. I'd like to see a lot more offense than we've seen up to this point. Give credit to the defenses, but I think you're going to see both these offense coordinators get more of a feel for things and start to adjust their play call.
And so far, it's been totally even. In close games like this, every possession is likely to matter. He heaves it deep. And they make the stop at the 4. So on first down, they go to the air and pick up huge yardage.
Well, that was just a well-executed play. They picked a perfect time to stretch the defense with a passing play, and it worked.
First and goal from the 3. They're knocking on the door. The short yardage defense here. He's taken down around the 3-yard line. Scrimmage. It's third down. They need 8 yards here to get the ball in the end zone.
Mike 55.
Got a man. He can't complete the play. LSU could take the lead with this field goal. The kick is up, and they tack on 3 points.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding them to a field goal right there.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Nice kick, plenty of distance. He's to the 20. And down he goes at the 23-yard line. The Tigers are looking downright scary on defense so far, Irby.
They are flying around as a group right now, completely aware of what this offense is trying to do and dismantling them every single time on every single play.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their mind. They just need to go out there and play. Gets it on the pitch. Brought down at the 21-yard line. Second and 13. Ball on their own 21. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with 5 wideouts. Fires quick out to the receiver and he can't make the grab. The intimidation factor is definitely here when you're playing in this stadium. Going deep, lays it out there. Nice play by the defense to bring up fourth down.
Yeah, instead of going for the interception, they did the safe thing, and that was just to tip it away.
Dillon will be the return man. He's at midfield. Tackle made at the 48-yard line. Boy, neither offense can find any kind of rhythm so far, Herbie.
Yeah, it almost feels like the two offenses are just kind of feeling their way right now, allowing both these defenses just to dominate the game.
Good job on their last drive, getting three. Let's see if they can get some more on this drive. LSU holds a field goal lead. They'll wrestle him down in the backfield. From their own 48-yard line. Second down. And down he goes at the 47-yard line. And the defense just swarmed over him on that one.
Yeah, they were able to penetrate the offensive line and get to the running back before that play even had a chance.
Check tight right. Go out there, check the outs out there.
Four down. Fires that quickly incomplete. And that'll bring up a punting situation.
Great hold by the defense. They were expecting the pass play, and they defended it very well.
Thomas is back deep to return. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Tigers really came prepared to play defense today, and the plan is working.
Well, so far in this game, you've got to tip your cap to the defensive coordinator. He has clearly done a very good job of getting his team ready to play, and they have done a nice job of slowing down this very explosive offense.
And while they are behind, they know they can knock things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. Strike to his receiver, no good. From their own 20-yard line, it's second down. He's out to the 30. And he's taken down around the 29-yard line. The crowd of this stadium, always a factor in a football game. Now he tries to buy some time. They bring him down. They get to the quarterback and end that play before it even got started.
This young man didn't even have a chance to make something happen. It's tough to find your receivers when the defense is in your face like that.
Dillon is the deep man awaiting the return. Fields it at the 40. He's taken down at the 50-yard line. So you wonder what kind of excitement we'll see this time around. LSU is up by three.
Oklahoma!
Quick pass, man open, and he dropped it. It's second and 10. Ball on the 50-yard line. At about the 41.
Not today. Check right.
They'll bring him down around the 38-yard line. Now they stuck with a run, and it pays off for them.
You know what, Brad? So important on third down to rely on the offensive line to get a good push, and that's what they did there to pick up the first down.
From the 38-yard line, it's first down. Makes it out to about the 30.
Man left. Four down. Mark 55.
Tackle made at the 30.
Two tight.
They got to him, and he did not get the first down.
I think the play call was the right one by the offense. I just think the defense made a better play. They seem to want it more here on this big third down. Offense comes up a little bit short to set up a fourth down, but give all the credit to the personnel on the defensive side of the ball.
He's got it out to his tight end. That play could not have come at a better time.
That was absolutely the perfect time to go with that play on fourth down.
From the 23-yard line, first down, LSU is up a field goal. He's tackled at the 21. This is the ninth play of this drive. He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line. From the 20-yard line, it's third down. It quickly. Almost picked off. Kicks up and it sails through the uprights. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play.
And he hits him hard at the 28. Second down at 7 coming up here. Ball on their own 28. Quickly, and that was almost picked.
The defense always likes to see a pass broken up, but getting the turnover would have been really big.
These fans are showing you why teams hate to come here, folks. Quick strike, and he drops it. Richards was the intended target, and that'll make it fourth down.
The offense really had nowhere to go on that one. The play was very well defended, and now the incompletion will force the fourth down and a punt.
Dillon, the return man. Makes it out to maybe the 40-yard line.
Every single time this offense has the ball, they're moving the football, but they're settling for field goals. And every time they settle for field goals, I've been watching the defense that they've been facing and watching how they run off the field to celebrate a job well done because they're not giving up touchdowns. That's a bad sign.
He's going to try and scramble, and he can't get away from the pressure. From their own 38-yard line, second down, in the shotgun and five wideouts.
Red two, kill, kill, kill.
Scrambling around. He gets sacked on the play. So the sack makes this third and very long. LSU with a 6-point lead. So the defense gets him to go three and out.
Good job here defensively forcing this incomplete pass.
The defense has everybody on the line. I think they're going to come after this one. Steps out of bounds at about the 31. And while they are behind, they know they can knock things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change the game plan. He zips it out to the right. And he's tackled
around the 39-yard line.
The receiver found a hole in the zone and turned it into a first down.
No matter what type of defensive coverage you have, there are always going to be holes. The best thing you can do is make those holes small so the quarterback can't get the ball in there.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 39. The offense going to try to open this field up, coming out in a five-wide set. And the defense counters with their dime look. And they make the stop
right around the 28-yard line.
Man left, man left. Three down, three down. Four to the right. Squeeze. Let's go. 3-19. 3-19.
He's scrambling. They bring the quarterback down. So it'll be second and 14 after the setback. Now he's scrambling. He's taken down
around the 30-yard line.
The crowd really making it difficult. Quick throw.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
He gets it up, and it's long enough, and he got it.
That one looked like cake for this kid. Chalk up 3 points for the offense.
6-3, LSU. Miami lines up for the kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He's to the 20. He's tackled at the 33.
Both sides have made their way back out, and we're just about set to get going again.
LSU has a three-point lead. Caught, open field, brought down at the 40-yard line. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. They work the right side, and there is nothing going there.
Larry, Larry, Larry! Mike 55! Mike 55! Come it!
Here we go.
Trying to set up a little screen, gets it to his tailback. Thomas is back awaiting the punt. Thomas fields it at the 26, and he's taken down at the 37.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play.
Off inside. He makes it to the 38-yard line. Second and 9. Ball on the 38-yard line. They spread the field in the gun with 5 wide receivers. Got his receiver, but it's knocked out. It's arguably the loudest crowd in the nation, and they are turning it up a notch. And his hands on it and dropped it.
It's an intelligent play by the defender. All you have to do sometimes is get your hand on the ball.
Dillon is back to receive. Heading for the corner. Dillon fields it at the 22, and they push him out at the 32-yard line. We're about set to start things up again. LSU holds a field goal lead. Hands it to the back, and he is drilled at the 31. Second and 10. Ball on the 31-yard line. And they got to him before he could get back to the line.
Defense. That was picture perfect, three and out. Good series for these guys.
Thomas awaiting the return. They'll bring him down at the 41. And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. Fires quickly, and he's got his man. And he's level at the 49. So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Down he goes, around the 48-yard line. You expect this every time you're here, and you're never disappointed. This crowd is amazing. Harley was the intended target on the play, and they're going to have to bring on the punt team.
The defense held their ground on that play. The quarterback just wasn't able to find any open receivers.
Dillon is back deep to return the punt. This punt bounces into the end zone, and this will be a touchback. The defense did a nice job shutting down the offense the last time they had the ball. LSU is up by three. Great run here, and he's got nowhere to go.
Too easy, too easy.
From their own 18-yard line, second down.
Hey, check five, check five. Check five.
Black five, black five.
He's on the run, and he's taken down around the 22-yard line. In quarter number one, but nonetheless, we've got a close game. 6-3, LSU. And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set to start the second quarter. Thomas, back to return it. Thomas fields it at the 38, brought down at the 44. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Wide open receiver, and it's incomplete. So it's second and 10.
Ball on the 44.
Makes it to the 44.
The reason why it's so crucial to be able to run effectively like this is it keeps the defense guessing. They have no idea whether you're passing or running, even if you need medium to long range yards.
From the 44-yard line, first down. Tackled after a decent run up the gut. Runs right for a nice gain. It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. The crowd at this stadium, always a factor in a football game. And he tackles him hard at the 35-yard line. Miami is down three and looking to tie it up. It's up, and he missed it left. No good. Momentum swings have been fairly even, and with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. LSU is up a field goal. Handoff, and he's met in the backfield. Loss of one there for the halfback. It's second and 11.
Ball on the 34.
Tackle made right around the 42-yard line. Incomplete.
I'm not so sure he made the best decision that time. That was a pretty tight area he was trying to throw that one into.
Thomas is back deep to return. He's out to the 30. He makes it to the 32-yard line. Richards' struggles continue now, and we're almost at halftime, Kirk. And he just hasn't been able to establish himself as any part of the offense, and right along with him, the offense is struggling and trying to find their identity.
Yeah, we all know that football is definitely a team game, and it's really not fair to put all this team's performance on just one player. I mean, if this guy is the emotional leader of this team, it seems like with him not being involved as much in the offense, I think it's really starting to affect him just by looking down and watching his body language on the sidelines. And you never want your teammates to see your frustrations like that or your opponent. Let's look for this coaching staff to try to talk to him, try to calm him down at halftime. And I think they need to inject a little bit of life to try to affect him and his team if they want to come back and win this second half.
Short yardage situation here. It's third and one. Becoming the 12th man, the crowd is always into it here. Quick shot to the open receiver, and he can't hang on to the ball. Dillon, back deep to return. Tackle made at the 25-yard line. You got to ask the question right now, is there going to be an offensive turning point in this game? Whoever busts through and makes a play will probably win the ball game. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. LSU has a three-point lead. He's tackled at the 26. Time right. It's second down and 8. Ball on the 26-yard line. And off to the left. They'll bring him down at the 29.
And he just gets rid of it.
Can't ask for much more than a three and out. Great job, defense.
Thomas will be the return man. Thomas fields at the 30. He gets out to about the 45-yard line. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays.
And they hit him in the backfield.
So it's second and 12.
Ball on their own 43.
And there's nowhere to run. Really a tough spot for an offense to be in against this crowd in this stadium.
He's going to air it long.
This one will fall incomplete. That'll make it fourth down, and they're going to have to punt.
It was a good hold by the defense on third down. Now their punt returner will get a chance to make something happen.
Dillon is the deep man awaiting the return. He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
LSU holds a field goal lead. Gets out to around the 38. Short yardage situation here. Second down and one. Sullivan takes it left. He's taken down right around the 36-yard line.
Thomas, the return man. Thomas fields at the 30. And they push him out right around the 48-yard line.
For the offensive coordinators, it's back to the drawing board.
Boy, this offense all of a sudden just can't do anything right. Nothing can impact an offense more negatively than being stopped on a series of downs.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays.
Flushed out, and he's going to get sacked.
Defense looking for another sack in this second down and long situation.
Looking to scramble down. He can't get away from the pressure.
Down now, and they need to get it down to the 38.
I don't know if they'll be able to hear his cadence in the midst of all this mayhem.
So they couldn't pick up the long yardage, and now they'll have to punt.
On third down, the defense was expecting the pass, and they defended the play very well in the secondary.
Dillon is back awaiting the punt. They bring him down, and they bring him down hard on that one. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. LSU is up by three. And he's tackled at about the 39-yard line. From their own 39-yard line, it's first down. He's at the 40. Tackle at about the 37-yard line. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 25-yard line. And they make the stop right around the 12-yard line. Take him down immediately. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Brought down at the 4. LSU is up a field goal.
Here we go. Orange three.
Runs it, and he stops short of the line of scrimmage.
You don't want that.
This one should be makeable. Kicks up, and it's through the uprights. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Excellent kick. He's to the 20. He's tackled at the 23-yard line. For LSU, they've been getting into the backfield quite a bit. This defense has been bringing the blitz and is having success getting to him. This offense is not only struggling in the pass protection department, they're struggling to get yards.
That's one of the effects of not being able to protect the quarterback. He's having to get rid of it in a hurry to a checkdown to avoid a sack.
With a narrow advantage, the defense is pumping up this crowd, trying to get him to help out. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. He gets to about the 34-yard line. From their own 34-yard line. First down. And down he goes at about the 29-yard line.
Once he saw it was a run, he made a great break on the ball and used his speed to make the big tackle.
Again, he'll get the call. He fights forward to about the 29. From their own 29-yard line, it's third down. They can't hear a thing down there. Hit as he threw, and he completes it. And he's taken down around the 33-yard line. receive. And down he goes at the 38-yard line. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. LSU is up by six. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. The ball, he picks it up. He fights forward to about the 43. They work hard and they got the turnover.
This is what it's all about. Defense taking advantage of an opportunity. They're pouncing on the loose ball.
And the booth is going to take a few looks at this to see whether or not the ball came out before he was down. So a big momentum shift could be in the making here as we take a look at the possible fumble. So the booth and the referee agree. The runner's knee was down.
That was still a close call, though, Brad. Even though he was down, this guy has to do a better job of holding that football.
Green nine.
Nice run there. Nice run there by the tailback, and it's good for the first.
Good running and a strong push to get into the second level of that defense.
First and 10. Ball on the 46. And he makes it out to about the 44-yard line. Quick strike, and he drops it.
That would have been pretty remarkable if he'd managed to hold on to the ball after taking a shot like that.
LSU with a 6-point lead. Is caught, the defense lays him out. It's fourth down, and the offense is getting set to go for it.
Mike 55.
He caught it, but they're not going to get it. He's tackled immediately.
Well, they decided to go for it, but the defense slammed the door on him. That's the definition of coming through when it matters most.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
Second and 10. Ball on the 37-yard line. Throws quickly, and it's almost intercepted. Listen to this place. Throwing right. Tackle made at the 39. From the 39-yard line, first down.
Three down. 24 is the mic. Here we go.
He goes downtown. Almost intercepted.
This is a very well-coached defense. They know to get their hands up in the air and to try to knock down passes.
Rid of this one. Third down now, and they need to get it to the 29. It's arguably the loudest crowd in the nation, and they are turning it up a notch. Throws quick to the receiver, and it falls incomplete. He'll try to change the field position and especially not get it to the end zone. So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. LSU up six. And he throws it away. So it's second and 10. Ball on their own 20. And he's tackled after positive yardage.
Man left, man left.
Four down, Mike 55, Mike 55.
Pass complete and taken down immediately. Everybody up close. It looks like they're coming after this kick. He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. He's taken down at the 38. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. He's scrambling. And they got him.
They've really thrown the quarterback's rhythm off and rattled his confidence with such a relentless pass rush. He's not himself out there at all today.
So the sack makes this a second and long. Throws it to the halfback on the screen. They'll bring him down around the 48-yard line. So it's third down, and they're just inches away from picking up the first down. This crowd can really be intimidating for an opposing team. And he tackles him hard at the 44-yard line. Dillon awaiting the return. He's out to the 30. He wasn't breaking that tackle. What a hit.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
LSU is up by six. He's tackled at the 33. And the halfback's got nowhere to go. Second and nine. Ball on the 33-yard line. They get nice yardage on that run. He has some room. And he carries the ball for a nice game. From their own 45-yard line, it's first down. He fights forward to about the 46.
Black, go!
They'll make the sack. Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 45.
Okay, long day for you.
Here we go.
Orange three. Go.
He's got to throw it in a hurry. He's taken down at the 44. So they try to fool him with the run, but the defense was all over it.
Great job here by the defense to penetrate the offensive line and get to the ball carrier before he got too many yards.
He fields a punt at the 20, and he's tackled at the 27. Momentum swings have been fairly even, and with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. He scrambles. And he's tackled around the 38-yard line.
A good quarterback knows when and how to improvise. And if he's got the skills, he can also turn a scramble into something big.
Now he tries to buy some time. He's wrapped up for the sack. He wants it all. That tackle could have saved a very big play. He's on the run. They bring him down. That's sack number 9. They got him again.
It's been quite a special game for this pass rushing defense.
So with the half ending, they're just going to try to put 3 points up on the board. Kicks away. And he got it.
Great snap and a perfect hold. And he just had an awesome follow through. Everything went right there on that long field goal.
9-6, LSU. They might just want to squib this one. Only a few seconds left here before halftime. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. LSU has a 3-point lead. He gets out to about the 28-yard line. Well, we've played a half of football. The Tigers with a 3-point lead.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half.
I'm a fan of seeing guys one-step wrap, two-step squeeze, bring your feet, arrive with bad intentions. I don't want to take anything away from these defensive guys, David, but could this be that we're seeing a healthy dose of some pretty bad offense, too?
It goes hand in hand, doesn't it, Reese?
Sometimes,
pretty good defense makes, you know, average offenses look really, really bad. But, you know, when you have a great defense and you can take something away, especially the strength of the other offense, and make them do things that they don't do exceptionally well, and, you know, don't let them throw the fastball, make them throw the curve. And you see great defenses be able to do that all the time, and that's when you can be ultra successful. You have to find ways to make people play, you know, the game out of their comfort zone.
David and I will stay locked in on everything going on in college football. It's going to wrap it up here in the studio. Just about time to get you out to your second half. Brad and Kirk ready with a call.
Great first half. Hopefully the second half's as good. He sends this one deep. He's to the 20. At the 30. He gets hit out of bounds. Right around the 48-yard line. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Setting up the play action.
Brought down around the 47-yard line.
So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first.
They make the stop at the 45.
You expect this every time you're here, and you're never disappointed. This crowd is amazing.
Tackle at the 32.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 32-yard line. His receiver dropped it. Incomplete.
Larry.
He laterals. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play.
Anytime a running back gets one-on-one with a safety, I think that running back has the confidence in his own athletic ability to be able to make that safety miss and get upfield for some yards. That time, the safety just dominated him, made a great tackle in the backfield for a short loss.
Third down again. Always a noisy place to play and tough on the offense. Boy, was he drilled as he let go of that football.
Yeah, he's going to feel that one tomorrow.
Miami is down three and looking to tie it up. Kicks up, and it's good.
You know, I was wondering if he's going to get a chance to kick one of those. We saw him warming up from 60 yards before the game.
Our score after the field goal, Miami 9, LSU 9. They line up to kick this one away. Excellent kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Time's getting a little bit tighter now. You got to make every possession count. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on their own 25.
Dog four. Run.
Taken down in the backfield.
The defense was playing run all the way right there, and it paid off for them.
Intended target on the play. That'll make it fourth down, and they're going to have to punt.
The defense held their ground on that play. The quarterback just wasn't able to find any open receivers.
Thomas will be the return man. He's tackled at the 48-yard line. I think it says something about the quality of the preparation of both teams that we're into the third quarter and nobody's been able to pull away. Both sides seem to know what to expect. Throws complete and he stopped immediately. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. He's taken down at the 33-yard line. Handoff to the right, and down he goes at the 31. From the 31-yard line. Second down. They go with the run, and he's taken down behind the line.
And this crowd is going absolutely crazy. Passes left, gets it out to the halfback. They'll drop him for a loss. Fourth down. They'll line it up for a very long field goal attempt. Miami could take the lead with this field goal. He gets it up, and it sails right on him. No good. Now's when you start to approach each drive thinking that if you take the lead, then the momentum you gain feels that much more powerful. Fires quick, tipped.
It looked like the quarterback thought he had an open receiver there, but I don't think he saw the linebacker.
From their own 33-yard line, it's second down. He's going to try and scramble. He's at midfield. Tackle made right around the 50. First and 10. Ball on the 50. Gets out to about the 48-yard line. They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. And he makes it out to about the 41-yard line. They're trying to pin them deep with a solid punt right here. He punts. No, he won't. Brought down at the 44-yard line. And they'll fail on fourth down. You don't want to squander any possessions, but maybe now's the right time to dip into your bag of tricks a little. Think about some gadget plays to catch the defense napping. And off up the middle, and he's stuffed. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 45-yard line. Bring him down behind the line. Really a tough spot for an offense to be in against this crowd in this stadium. And he is drilled at the 48. Sack makes this a fourth and very long. Dillon is back deep to return. He's got the corner. He's out to the 30, and they push him out at the 31-yard line. A lot of times you'll see teams start to clinch up a little bit when games stay close well into the second half. You need to stay loose, keep doing what you've been doing all week in practice, and execute when it's time. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. And he stopped behind the line.
fourth down.
The offense really had nowhere to go on that one. The play was very well defended, and now the incompletion will force the fourth down and a punt.
They're stacking the line. It looks like they're coming after this punt. He gets out to about the 45-yard line. And for Lawrence, he's been making his presence felt.
Well, he has tremendous quickness, and overall, I think he's just been a big headache for this offensive line the entire game. I think he really has done a good job of just making his presence felt by this offense. In fact, if you're the offense, you got to account for him on every single play.
In a game this tightly contested, it comes down to which defense is playing better. Time's getting a little bit tighter now. You got to make every possession count. He's flushed and they got it. They come up to the line here. It's second down and 14 after the sack. After a decent pickup.
Check 82, watch 82, ball coming 82.
They can't hear a thing down there. Crosses out to the tailback on the screen. To the 20. He's tackled around the 14-yard line. And the big pickup through the air has made it first and 10.
Three down, three down. Mike six! Mike six!
They'll bring him down right around the 14-yard line. Taken down around the 12-yard line. And so it's another third down upcoming here. One of the top stadiums in the nation. This crowd comes to play themselves. And he can't get away from the pressure. Miami is looking to go up by three. It's up, and they tack on 3 points. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Sends it sailing downfield. He gets out to about the 18-yard line. Miami's the type of team, when you look at them, it looks like their defense sort of just feeds off itself.
I think the energy is there, Brad, but I think it really starts up front with their defensive line and their linebackers. The way they're being able to just win the battle at the line of scrimmage, I think it's giving them confidence, and it's allowing them to play more downhill where they can attack this offense.
And he's tackled at the 17-yard line. We've got a second and 11. Ball on the 17-yard line. They'll give it off here. And they tackle him at the 42-yard line. Side. He makes
makes his way to about the 48. It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker. He's at the 40. Gains his way to the 30-yard line. From the 28-yard line, second down. Fires quickly, and he's got his man, and he's hit immediately. Receiver. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 20. Gets to about the 17-yard line. We're at play number 9 of this current drive. Here's a screen pass, gets it to the back, brought down at about the 13.
That's where you fly to the ball.
So it's fourth down. They'll call on the field goal unit here. LSU can tie it up here with this kick. Kicks away, and he's got it. Tracy looks ready to kick this one off. He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 20. He's taken down at the 28-yard line. I think it says something about the quality of the preparation of both teams that we're into the third quarter and nobody's been able to pull away. Both sides seem to know what to expect. Tackle at about the 29-yard line. From their own 29-yard line, it's second down. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. Fires quick to an open man. He dropped it. I don't know if they'll be able to hear his cadence in the midst of all this mayhem. Sets up a screen, tailback's got it, and they make the stop around the 35-yard line. Dillon is back deep to return the punt. He makes it out to maybe the 36-yard line. Now's when you start to approach each drive thinking that if you take the lead, then the momentum you gain feels that much more powerful. And they get nice yardage on that run.
That's what I'm talking about, baby.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Gets to about the 44-yard line.
Reset, cut right. Mike 55.
Quick strike, and he drops it. Jefferson was the intended receiver on that pass. So that'll make it fourth down.
Great hold by the defense. They were expecting the pass play, and they defended it very well.
Thomas, the return man.
He's out to the 30. Tackle at the 41-yard line.
You don't want to squander any possessions, but maybe now's the right time to dip into your bag of tricks a little. Think about some gadget plays to catch the defense napping.
He's at midfield, and he tackles him hard at the 47.
From the 47-yard line, first down.
Gets out to around the 32. Slings it right. So on first down, they go to the air and pick up huge yardage.
Well, that was just a well-executed play. They picked a perfect time to stretch the defense with a passing play, and it worked.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. Hands it to the back. Touchdown, Hurricanes! The halfback just plowed his way into the end zone.
Yeah, but it wasn't all him. The offensive lineman just pancaked the defense on that one.
And he converts the extra point. A four-play, 58-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
Miami to kick this one off. And he got all of this one. Great kick. He's to the 20. And he's tackled at the 28.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense.
The run. Nice run, and he's brought down.
From their own 32-yard line, second down.
Here we go.
Nice run to the left there.
Down 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 44.
Straight ahead on the give, and there's nowhere to run.
The 49.
Third down again.
Two times.
Four down.
The running back gets a yard, maybe less. Pope back deep to return.
This punt goes over the goal line, and this will be a touchback. It's a new possession for this offense, so what will it hold?
Miami is up a score. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line.
That's three down and one to go. The Hurricanes with a touchdown lead. Back in this very pivotal fourth quarter.
Three down. Mike City.
Goes over the middle, intercepted.
And down he goes,
right around the 28-yard line. Reception breathes new life into this team.
I'm not quite sure I would have made that pass. It obviously wasn't open. This quarterback's got to be more conservative with the ball when they have the lead late in the game like this.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 28. Nice run there. It up the middle for a nice run. From the 15-yard line, it's first down.
Red 2. Easy.
Run. And he's tackled after positive yardage. Away here on third down.
Three down. Mike 55.
Tailback brought down for a loss.
He just timed the snap count there and really made a nice play.
The catch, and look out, he's out of bounds at the 10-yard line. Their last drive ended with an interception. We're about to find out what the defense can do this time.
Anytime you give the ball away, it's a disappointment. So these guys want to show that they can hang on to it.
Here's the throw, and I don't think he got anything on that. From their own 10-yard line. It's second down. Miami is up 7. Tackle made at about the 17-yard line. The crowd really making it difficult. Tackled right away. Quick out to his receiver.
The offense gets a first down here, and you got to give him some credit. But really, this is more about the defense. When a defense gets an offense to third down and medium, you've got to be able to put pressure on the quarterback, especially when they're passing the football, and try to get your own offense the ball back. And that time, they let their own offense down.
From their own 24-yard line, second down. Go the run, and he's tackled in the backfield for a loss.
fans are showing you why teams hate to come here, folks. He throws it. They'll bring him down
around the 47-yard line.
It definitely put them in better field position, and I just have a feeling that they're going to punch it into the end zone on this drive.
From the 47-yard line, first down. He makes his way to about the 38. This is the eighth play of this drive. Miami is up by a touchdown. He's taken down at the 37. From the 37-yard line, first down. Pressured and brought down. And this is the 10th play of the drive. Up the middle. He's tackled at the 41. Nowhere to go for the halfback. That's a loss of one. They line up for another third down, and they've had no problem converting their first two. Really one of the very tough places to play in college football, and it's no different today. Under heavy pressure, and he's tackled around the 27-yard line. We're at the 12th play of the drive.
Watch the pass. Watch the pass. Let's go. Hey, Mike 40.
He makes his way to about the 18. It's second down now. They're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Quick throw, the five, touchdown, Canes. And that completion gives him over 300 yards through the air.
Well, this quarterback has had a solid game. He's done what's been asked of him, and then some.
He hits the PAT. So a 13-play, 89-yard drive, and they get it in for seven.
You know, Brad, a lot of times you have to watch practice and watch a 7-on-7 drill to not see the ball touch the ground. This time they went the entire length of the field. The ball never touched the ground. Great execution by the quarterback and receiver.
And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. He's hit before it can go anywhere. From their own 35-yard line, it's first down. Brought down at the 48-yard line. It right, nice pickup. We've got a second and five. Ball on the 47.
Go
feeds it to the back. That's a great tackle at the 46-yard line.
Mike 55, Mike 55. Eat, 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 eat. Red 2.
takes it out to about the 44-yard line. Looks like they've decided to go for it here. Gains his way to the 36-yard line. There was some movement on the line.
Maybe he got the cadence wrong coming out of the huddle. The coaches have a low threshold for mistakes like that.
First and 15 now after the penalty. Throws it away. And this is the eighth play of the drive. Inside give. Tackled after a decent pickup. So they get 5 yards there on the halfback draw. Third down now, and they need to get it to the 26. Throws out and through his hands.
Here we go. Tight right. Four down. Hey, check right.
Ready? He airs it out. Incomplete.
When the first down marker is that far away, someone's got to step up and make a play on fourth down. It just didn't happen for him here.
You aren't going to convert many fourth downs against this defense. That's a really good stop. Let's find out if the defense has made any adjustments after giving up a touchdown on that last drive.
As long as this quarterback has time to throw, then you can guarantee that he'll find the open man.
He's at midfield. He's at the 40. And he's finally shoved out at the 30. So it's first and 10 after the big run.
Let's go, let's bring it.
Mike 40.
Screen to the back, no good. Left side, and he shoved out of bounds at the 31. Loss of one there for the halfback. Third down, and they need to get it down to the 20. Set up a little screen, gets it to his tailback. Tackle at about the 27-yard line. It's up, looks long enough. And it hits the upright and bounces through. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Dillon from the 2. Tackle made at the 27. So they're just about set to get the game going again. Hits him hard at the 22-yard line. From their own 22-yard line, second down.
Mike 55, Mike 55.
picked off.
Certainly, they don't have the return on here.
Brought down at the 44-yard line. The offense ready to go again. And their last drive ended with 3 points.
Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun.
He's scrambling. And they make the stop
around the 49-yard line.
Second and five coming up here. Ball on their own 49. Makes it out to about the 43.
Nowhere, baby. Let's go. Way to go. Ready. Black and five. Motion.
And he tackles him hard at the 46. The 46-yard line. It's second down. They come out on an empty backfield. Quick throw out to the receiver. Incomplete. Here they come. He zips one over to the right, and it's picked off.
Not only did he demonstrate his leaping ability, but he also has the hands to be able to pull the ball in. Great job.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on their own 25. Takes it right and brought down right away.
Right and left. Four down. Mike 55. Eat. Red two.
Check. Dancer.
Motion.
Go. Quick strike to the receiver. And he's taken down around the 36-yard line. From their own 36-yard line. First down.
Back five. Three.
The cavalry's coming. They'll make the sack. Defense looking for another sack in the second down and long situation.
Three down.
Hey, check five. Nearly intercepted. Incomplete. And it's the offense that takes the field on fourth down.
Watch nine.
Slings it. Oh, he had a shot at the pick.
threw a pick the last time out. Should be interesting to see what they do this time.
Giving the ball away can rattle your confidence, but he just needs to relax and not try to force it. He's starting off in great field position now.
They bring their quarterback down. From the 30-yard line, second down. The offense going to try to open this field up, coming out in a five-wide set, and the defense counters with their dime look. And a quick throw. He's knocked out of bounds around the 17-yard line. Scooped up, and down he goes at the 23. They find themselves in a hole here after that sack at second and long. Slides down to the ground. Try for 3 points. Less than 3 minutes in the game. The kick is up, and it sails through the uprights. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field.
Watch the run. They're running it. Right. Five. Right there. Right. Five.
Slings it. He's to the 40. And they push him out at about the 45.
A pass like that is so hard to defend because the defender doesn't have a great play on the ball unless it's underthrown. It's all based on connection between the quarterback and his receiver.
He's level at the 44. There's a strike complete, and he's finally knocked out of bounds at the 14-yard line.
It's going to be tough for this team, obviously, to get back into the football game, but I just love to see the pride they're playing. They are determined to play until the final whistle, and they're not giving up. You hear that, kids? They're not giving up, and that's a key.
And he is drilled at the 9. Ball inside the 10-yard line. Second down.
35's the mic.
Black 5, black 5, blue 4.
Yeah, I need one of
them. Tackle made at the 3-yard line.
Come on. Mike 35.
Just under 2 minutes
black
in the game.
Five.
He's tackled at the 1-yard line.
Ready.
from the 1 yard line. It's second down. And he just gets rid of it.
Great job by the defense of getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
This is the eighth play of this drive. A short yardage defense here.
Hey, kill, kill, kill!
They go to the back, and he's hit immediately in the backfield. The Tigers will use their first time out of the half. So the offense is going for it. It's fourth down, and we're on the 2 yard line. He's taken down at the 6 yard line. The defense was able to keep him out of the end zone on their last possession, but the offense did pick up three. They'll bring him down at the 7 yard line. They line up at the 7. Second down.
I'll give the defense all the credit here. They had that one snuffed out from the start. It could have been an even bigger loss.
And this one comes to an end. Our final count in this game, Miami 32, LSU 12. That does it for this edition of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.